Hi, this is Cass from Aussie Cass Plays. Welcome to a video. I've never done one like this before. As you'll know from the title, it is a current household video. You won't recognize this house, but you may recognize some of these Sims. If you've watched my weird science Let's Play, you'll know the Sim that I've got selected here at the moment. This is Hayley, except she didn't used to wander around without her disguise off. Back when I did that Let's Play, we almost never saw her without her disguise off. She was trying to blend in. Hayley's backstory, and this saves you from having to watch the Let's Play. It's mega spoilers, but you know, that's probably quicker. Hayley crash landed her spaceship in Oasis Springs. She was trying to blend in. She got a little tiny house. The welcome wagon showed up. The only one in it was Johnny Zest because she was in that neighborhood. She and Johnny struck up a relationship. He eventually found out she was an alien. Like, didn't take that long. She wasn't very good at hiding it. She kept using her powers on people. She still does it. And they got together. She became a scientist because she was trying to reach out to other aliens and figure out if there was a way she could get home. But ultimately, she and Johnny fell in love, got married. She got pregnant on their honeymoon, and at that point she was kind of like, well, I guess I'm staying here, I'm not going back to Sixham. So it was very sweet. She had a pair of twin girls, who are Alara and Astrid. Alara and Astrid have like lavendery kind of purple skin, but are human. They don't have any alien powers, but they can't, because of that, they can't use disguises, so they're purple. Ultimately, Johnny, a couple of things happened towards the ends of the Let's Play. Johnny got abducted by an alien who I actually created in my game because I thought it was more fun than Senior Pollinator number 3. And that was Andromeda. He got pregnant with Sirius, who is this second sim here along the bottom. I will introduce you to these guys in a sec. He's feeling sad. It's a bit surprising to me. He wasn't feeling sad last time I loaded this file. Anyway, Sirius is an alien. He can pass as an alien. He was adopted by Hayley. She's raised him as her mother. He doesn't really know Andromeda. And then the other thing that happened was Hayley cloned herself. And this is important. As part of the science career, you can create a cloning machine. She has a little lab down here. The main house I actually downloaded from the gallery. Then I built her greenhouse and like a lab and science building at the back, which I really love. So this is her lab. This is her cloning machine. She cloned herself. I thought it would create like a temporary clone, like what happens in Realm of Magic when you create, like cast a spell on yourself. It did not. It created a permanent new sim who is a member of her household. And that permanent new sim's name is June Rover. So we have Hayley Rover and June Rover. The game treats them as siblings. So she ended up with an identical twin sister who's younger than her, because that's just how it worked. So June, to help Hayley track down the alien who had kidnapped Johnny and gotten him pregnant against his will, entered law enforcement. And ultimately they tracked Andromeda down and Johnny confronted her and there was a big argument and it was a whole thing. So that was sort of where we left it. Now, things have gotten complicated since then, like Days of Our Lives complicated. So they moved house out of Oasis Springs. So this is Hayley in her non-disguise. They moved house out of Oasis Springs. They're now in Windenburg in this beautiful old house, which again, like I said, we've modified to suit her interests. I'll give you a quick tour. All these decorations are things I brought from Oasis Springs or have since purchased. So, you know, nice. I should put all the lights on so you can see. Turn on all lights. So we've got a beautiful little kitchen here. Nice little dining room. Just clean that up. Jeez, did they not know we were going to have guests? We've got, you know, beautiful dining table. Some of this stuff's custom content, some of it's not. Some projects and stuff. I have a little sort of big bathroom here, a little two-way toilet. We've got the main bedroom here. This originally was Johnny's studio thing. And this bit was actually just part of the main hallway. And then upstairs, we've got Sirius's bedroom, which he's sort of in the middle because he's only just recently aged up to being a teen, and I haven't really found his vibe yet. So we still need to kind of, there's some stuff in here that's like, he was super into Void Critters when he was a kid and stuff. So there's some stuff I haven't quite modified. And here we have Alara's bedroom and Astrid's bedroom. Alara's bedroom was full of instruments, but they've actually, the two girls have both recently moved out. So there's a bunch of stuff missing from these rooms. But they're still like that for when they come to visit. So what happened? A couple of things happened in fairly rapid succession. Johnny got abducted again by aliens. He was coming out here to, I think, go in the pool. It was nighttime. Mistakes were made. He got abducted, and I'll just leave that there for now. Well, that's worth a lot of money. He got pregnant with twins, which is these two here. So we have Nova and we have Mars. Yes, Mars Zest Rover and Nova Zest Rover, because I am mean. So they're cute. They're aliens. I edited their genealogies so that they have the same parent, Andromeda. So Sirius and Nova and Mars are actually all full siblings. Just because, again, like I said, I like it better than senior pollinator number three or number whatever. I don't actually remember what the number of Sirius's senior pollinator parent was originally. Their skin tones are slightly different though, so I suspect they were different senior pollinators. I've decided they're the same, so that's the thing. So we've got these kids here, and then we were having a summer celebration party, and Haley had gone out to her lab to do something. I can't even remember what. She might have been using the bathroom because we had a lot of guests over. And I was far enough away from the house that I didn't notice anything. I didn't hear anything. Suddenly she got a moodlet saying that she had a drifting partner or drifting love or something, or betrayed. It was one of those like big time betrayed moodlet. And I was like, Johnny, what have you done? Naturally. It's like, outraged. So I came to check on him, and he had just woohooed in the closet with June, who is Haley's clone slash sister. But remember Haley's clone? So he cheated with the clone of his wife. But from her point of view, from Haley's point of view, he still cheated. So she was indignant, as you would be, and she tossed him out on his ear. So he then was like, oh, okay, where am I gonna go? I know, I'll bunk down with June temporarily. She's in San Myshuno. She moved there a while back, like before any of this happened. She'd actually moved out and gone to the city to pursue her dreams of being a cop. So that's where this little house is at. We've got Haley. I'm gonna go visit the other houses in a sec. We've got Haley with three kids that she's looking after. They're all aliens. None of them are biologically hers. But the reason that Johnny has left the children, especially the younger two, I mean, Sirius has chosen to stay where he is because he's a bit annoyed with his dad, and Haley has raised him from a baby. Johnny could have chosen to take the younger two twins with him, but he didn't because he's in a tiny little apartment in San Myshuno. And because they're aliens and he's not an alien, and even though he's living with June, who is technically an alien because she's the clone of an alien, are you following me? Stay with me here, guys. She's an alien, but she has no cultural knowledge of Sixsom. She's never been, like, she's been there once. Haley took her to visit once. She has no, like, she didn't grow up there. She knows nothing about Sixsom. So Johnny thought it would be better for his kids to learn from Haley. And Haley, despite the fact that they're not her kids, I mean, she has adopted them, she does love them, and she would afford Johnny tooth and nail for these kids. And frankly, Haley is fearsome. So there's been a couple of other changes in Haley's life. She, when Johnny left, decided, stuff it. Why am I hiding who I am? I tried hiding who I was, and my husband has left me. he's off, you know, he's shacked up with my sister slash clone, who actually has a different personality to Haley. I changed the personality traits to suit a new sim, like a brand new born sim clone thing. So, you know, he's gone for the young, he's literally traded in for the younger model. So bugger it, basically. So hence the new I don't wear disguises anymore thing. The other thing that's changed is she'd actually reached the top of the scientist career and she'd maxed out her aspiration. So I switched her across to Renaissance Sim and she actually wants to reach level 3 in 3 careers. She's not going to probably check that off because she's just switched across to being an astronaut and it's an easy switch for her. Like, she got offered it because of her reputation and she's already got a bunch of skills at level 10 because I've been playing this sim for a long time. Including rocket science. She already had rocket science at level 10, so I figure astronaut should be a bit of a doddle. Anyway, that is this household. This is part one of three. Not the video, but the household. I will now take you to Johnny. All right, here we have Johnny. Ooh, Zest. Uh-huh. Johnny has just staged up to be an elder. He is on the friend of the world aspiration. He maxed out the comedian, I can't even remember, jokester, whatever it is, aspiration. And he's a showstopper, so he's maxed out the comedy career. Now, I think he's sad for the same reason that Sirius was sad. Because I actually, even though Johnny in The Sims 4 didn't have any relationships, it says in his bio that he's Malcolm's brother and the child of Nancy and Jeffrey. The game would only let me add in Jeffrey and not Nancy, so I don't know what that says. I don't know if that means that, and when I say the game, I mean MC Command Center. I don't know if that means that Johnny perhaps wasn't Nancy's, was like a half-sibling. I don't know. Anyway, he's apparently sad, even though he had no real relationship with Malcolm. Now, this is June, who's feeling tense because of a crying toddler. Why are you crying? Oh, because your uncle died. I mean, that'd do it. All right. Do you know how to go to the toilet? No. Oh my God. I just did that thing that I do. Are you toilet trained? I can't remember. Yes. Yes, you are. All right. Come up here, buddy. Now, I am playing with this sim and I haven't even told you who he is yet, but you can probably guess. So June and Johnny woohooed one time. I don't know if it was a risky woohoo. I don't know if it was a hookup. I didn't see the interaction. This is June. This is what Haley would look like if she were in disguise and went blonde, which she could do because she has alien disguises. But yeah, she's a very pretty sim. Very, very pretty sim. She's a cop. She's fit. She's looking buff. She's actually fitter than Haley, which feeds into that whole training up for a younger model biz. But June got pregnant. So Johnny came to the city to move in with June, only to discover that she was pregnant with his child. What that means is that Johnny Zest has 6 children. This is the part I love of this whole family. He has 2 children with his alien wife, who are not aliens. He has 3 children as a result of being abducted that he gave birth to himself, because that is how abductions work in The Sims. And he has 1 child who is the son, human, not alien. So these 3 human, despite being purple, these 3 alien with disguises, so they look human. This one, human child, purple skin, biologically, even though the game knows that he's a half-brother of Alara and Astrid, biologically, genetically, he would be a full brother because his mother is the clone of their mother. I love this so much. So this is Jack. I don't really know much about Jack yet. I have played in this house a bit, but I confess I have been focusing a bit more on Haley because I've been exploring Salvadorada and all that kind of stuff. Oh, it says you're asleep. Oh, you are. And this is June's cat, because when she moved to the city, she got a cat. Her name is Pixel. It's very cute. Downloaded from the gallery. I actually can't remember the name of the cat on the gallery, but I basically searched for robot cats or robot pets, and this is what I found. So this is Pixel. This is June's alien cat, and I love her. And she is probably my favorite sim in this whole thing. So, the other sims. But wait, there's two more sims we have to catch up with. All right, this is our final house. Oh, we're also feeling sad. I just don't remember Malcolm dying while I was playing. It must have just happened just as I loaded this file up. Anyway, this is, I forget the name of the EA lot. It's in Brightchester. So Alara and Astrid, when they finished high school, moved to Brightchester. They spent a couple of, like, they spent their first year at the dorm. I think they're in Darkwing. So they were living in the dorm. And then I decided I wanted to have them move out into a house. But I think I clicked the wrong button and they ended up moving into, like, I thought they were going to move into a university house, but not into an actual house, like a normal house, a non-university house. So I accidentally basically made them homeless. They didn't have a lot of money. I decided not to get money from Haley or Johnny or June or anyone else. So I decided that I'd move them into the cheapest possible lot. And for a while they were sleeping on airbeds and it was all quite grim. But Alara is an incredibly talented musician. I'll just show you her skills. It helps that they both got the talented trait. She's painting 10, piano 10, singing 10, guitar 10, violin 10, pipe organ 8. So we need to obviously work on our pipe organ skills. So she's got an amazing ability to sustain herself because she... No, you got the food out. Eat the food. She's got an amazing ability to, like, sustain a household because she can, like, bash out a painting and have it be masterwork. And then it's worth a ton of money, which basically means Alara has been paying for this house effectively on her own. So this is her bedroom. I've actually only just added... They were originally living in tiny bedrooms in here. This was two bedrooms up here. So I've split it in two. Alara got the big room, partly because she has a ridiculous number of hobbies. Like, I've got an easel and a keyboard and everything in here. And partly because she's basically bankrolling this house. Astrid spends all of her time when she's not doing classwork working on... Well, she's in the Secret Society and she's on the Ubright football team, soccer team, whatever you want to call it. So she's in that team, which means when she's not... And that is, like, an intense commitment because they... Hang on, where does it show it again? Yeah. She's up to being a playmaker for the team. And they... It's, like, every day. It's a massive time commitment. And then she comes home and she's shattered. So even though we didn't really need the sports scholarship, she's got it anyway. So this is why Alara's kind of carrying the can for the household a bit. Now, I have added a third bedroom on. I originally had a housemate, but then the game glitched and I had to actually move the Sims out and move them back in. It was the only way I could restore the game file. Like, it was actually freaking out completely. So we currently don't have a roommate. That's next on my list of things to do with these guys. I love my little shower, by the way. Let me just show you. This is the Discover University shower, which is just, like, on the wall. And I put in a big window on it, like a wall coming out. And I think it's super cute. Got, like, a glass shower. And there's actually a modicum of privacy. Like, you can go to the toilet here, and even though it's glass and it's open, the Sims will use the bathroom and not mind. So Alara is studying. They're currently doing a much lighter course load because now they're trying to also maintain the house and stuff. So they were doing, I think, 3 or 4 units each when they were on campus. But she's doing biology. My plan is for her to get into the athlete career because I've never played that. And Alara is doing fine art. So she's GPA of A, Astrid's A minus. And yeah, I mean, Alara's, it's almost redundant for her because, you know, this semester she's doing painting and I decided to put her in an elective of media production, but she doesn't actually need painting skill. But on the other hand, she should get A's in it because it should be pretty easy because she already knows how to do it. So, yeah, that is my family. From a relationship point of view, of all of the Sims I've talked to you about, only Joni and June are in relationships at the moment. Hayley is single and super not interested. You know, she's just gotten out of a marriage where the human that she fell in love with betrayed her, and she's zero interest. I think, you know, Sirius would be interested, but I haven't sort of played with him much since he became... Oh, we just maxed out the cooking skill. Good work, Alara. I haven't played him, really, since he became a teen, because it was around about the same time these guys moved out, and I've been wanting to play Discovery University, so that's what I've been doing. Astrid... Alara's still single, and she's, I think, gotten drunk at some keg parties and maybe done a little bit of flirting. Let's have a look. Yeah, she's flirted with a few Sims. Oh, hang on, that's Astrid. Astrid's woohooed with people. Yeah, Alara's actually flirted with nobody. Astrid, who's our redhead Sim here, has woohooed with, I think, Sam and Austin, but no strings, kind of, like they're not in relationships. She started flirting with Erica. Erica was the Sim that moved in with us for a little while. And then kind of the game glitched, basically. So, yeah, that's kind of where we're at. I don't know where either of these girls are going to end up. I've got careers in mind for them. Obviously, Alara's going to be in some manner of music, I would expect. Yeah, she's basically paying for the house on, like, song lyric licensing. So she's got songs licensed for all of these. She's also licensed some lyrics, and once she gets more pipe organ skill and we get a ridiculous great honking pipe organ in this house, we're gonna license one of them as well. I assume we can. Yeah, so that is my current household. If you'd be interested in seeing anything more with these Sims, then let me know in the comments, because I'm having a lot of fun playing them. And I'd be happy to make more videos. Otherwise, maybe I'll do another video down the track, you know, when these guys have, like, gotten in relationships or had kids, and we can see how crazy the family tree has gotten, because this save file, alien abductions are a thing. Like, Alara's been abducted twice since she moved to Brightchester. Fortunately, she can't get pregnant from it. Only male Sims can. So, you know, that's okay. Anyway, I'm going to leave this here. If you've enjoyed, like and subscribe. You know the drill. And I will catch you next time. Thanks for watching.